Treatment of the pregnant patient has the potential to affect the lives of two individuals, the mother and the unborn fetus.
Hello and welcome to Dentistry 101, your source for online dental education. We hope that you enjoy.
Inside of the oral cavity, hormonal changes could cause gingival hyperplasia or pyogenic granuloma due to vascular response to the increased progesterone, usually at sites with the pre-existing gingivitis. Pyogenic granuloma is a bright red hyperemic and edematous lesion, which often occurs in the anterior papilla of the maxillary teeth. It could be treated by scaling and root planning, and could be surgically removed if it is large and has bleeding. Pregnancy does not cause periodontal disease, but it could worsen an existing periodontal condition. This happens because the estrogen found in the saliva causes the proliferation and the desquamation of the oral mucosal cells in the mouth, which provides a good environment for the bacterial growth, which increases the dental caries in the pregnant woman. This could be prevented by having good oral hygiene. Some pregnant women, because of the hormonal changes, could experience mobility of the teeth. This condition is reversible. Recent studies show that scaling and cleaning the teeth by the dentist is recommended for the pregnant woman because it improves the maternal health. Dentists need to use a safe position for the pregnant woman when providing dental treatment to avoid any complications, such as the pregnant patients could have a hypotensive syndrome if the dental chair was in a supine position. The best position to treat the dental patient is to make her tilted by 5 to 15 degrees on her left side. If the patient starts to feel hypotension, the patient should be asked to have a full left lateral position, especially during the third trimester. Drugs are not recommended to be given for the pregnant patients, especially during the first trimester. The most safe analgesic for the pregnant woman is the acetaminophen. Prolonged use of acetaminophen is not recommended because it could cause neonatal depression and could cause hepatotoxicity in large amounts. It should not be used more than 4 grams per day. Using NSAIDs such as ibuprofen could be prescribed during the first and the second trimester, but not for a long duration. The best line of treatment for the pregnant woman is the direct intervention by the dentist and removing of the cause of the pain, either by doing root canals or extracting of the infected tooth. Concerning antibiotics, antibiotics should only be given when the patient shows a sign of spread of the oral infection, such as facial cellulitis or an increase in the body temperature. The safest antibiotic to be used during pregnancy is the amoxicillin. Tetracyclines should be avoided for all pregnant and lactating women and avoided in children up to 12 years because it causes permanent dental staining. Lidocaine and prilocaine are considered to be safe dental anesthesia. Epinephrine-free dental anesthesia should be used to not affect the utero-placental blood flow. Concerning the dental radiation for the pregnant woman, it is recommended to avoid any unnecessary radiation such as diagnostic radiation. During root canals, the apex locator could be used to determine the working length. The obturation of the root canal could be delayed until delivery. Glass ionomer could be used as a temporary filling instead of the normal temporary filling during the time of the pregnancy.
And this brings an end to our video. If you like the video, please hit like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.